I'm from Italy.
From Italy?
Greece.
I live in Tokyo, so I came from Tokyo too.
Recently from Montreal, Canada.
I'm from Italy.
I'm from India.
Taiwan.
What's your native language?
Italian.
Greek.
I'm a native Japanese speaker.
My native language is English.
It depends on, it's possibly Italian, even if I'd say partly it's Piemontese, which is a small language spoken in northwestern Italy, but mostly I grew up in Italian, so.
It's Tamil, because I come from a state of Tamil Nadu in the south of India.
Taiwan, we got maybe two kinds of major language. One is kind of just like Chinese, another kind is Taiwanese. And some similar, but some quite different. And Taiwan still has some Aboriginal language, Hakkanese, and many kinds of too many. But I think the major one is Chinese and Taiwanese. I speak in Taiwanese because my mother and my father speak Taiwanese in family. So my first mother language should be Taiwanese. And then I grow up in school, we need to speak in Chinese. If we don't, we get punished.
How did you learn English?
Well, I learned it in high school, and then I had frequent study periods abroad in Ireland, in other countries. And living abroad, English is my first language now, somehow, English and Chinese.
Well, as a kid, I grew up in a tiny little town. There's no entertainment whatsoever for kids, except for playing outside or find your own stuff to do. So I had a radio, and here in the country area, you get this FM band from the American base nearby. Back then it was called FEN, Far East Network. Now it's the American Forces Network, and I listened to it a lot.
Partly at school, and then I went to England for a number of times when I was a kid to spend some weeks and learn the language. And then I really learned it only when I had to use it for my job. So by working in international companies, I had to actually practice it and learn it.
Thankfully, the Indian education system enforces upon you that you got to learn English right from your kindergarten. So I guess that's how.
How did you learn Japanese?
I learned Japanese. I took a few courses here and there. So when I first came to Japan, which was almost 5 years ago, I took a class, and that got me a little bit started. And then after that, I kind of stopped for a while. And then I took another class for 4 months. And then I was somewhere kind of around below intermediate level, so I could communicate. But then at that point, I was living in Japan, and I said, you know, if you live in Japan and you don't speak Japanese, you kind of see a very limited part of the country, especially, it depends on your level, but I really felt like, okay, I really want to get the experience that Japanese people have. So then and I think you need a goal besides language. That's really, I always tell people, you know, I teach English sometimes, and I always tell people, if you want to learn English, you need a goal other than English. English shouldn't be the goal, because if English is a goal, it's really just a language. And so my goal was really, I want to learn more about the country I'm in. I was interested in, you know, basically everything. I mean, you know, what's going on around me. So I started studying a lot, and I took classes, but I also studied by myself a lot.
Do you have any advice for people who are learning English?
Don't study, just, you know, get out and talk with people.
Well, the general advice to people who are learning languages is to use the language, to go to the country where they have to use it every day. So that's the main advice. And then, of course, if there is no interest in the language in the first place, then you can put all the effort you want and you're never going to learn it. So that's particularly true with Asian languages like Chinese, Japanese, more difficult languages. So cultural interest is also very important.
Internet, just YouTube, internet in all forms, Wikipedia, just use content. Listen to the lyrics of the songs, watch movies. That's my basic advice, and read literature. So on the internet, or if you are into art, go to Yubu Web. If you're just into content, just check your YouTube, or check the music sites, content, and internet. That's my advice.
Yeah, listen to the radio. There's like a lot of different mediums out there that you can use. You don't have to pay a lot of money to go to all these conversation schools or, you know, buy very expensive teaching materials. You just go out and buy it yourself. You know, you have the internet now. Like, it's free. You have the connection. Radio, TV, magazines.
I think a lot of Japanese people fall in this trap of focusing on English. And so you see Japanese people, and this always happens, that they will come to you and try to use this very, very complicated English, which actually nobody really uses it when they're native English speaker. Because the goal that they're aiming for is to have really amazing, wonderful English instead of trying to communicate. The goal should be always communication and trying to learn. So actually a lot of people who speak Japanese well, and this is not the case for me, but a lot of people who speak Japanese well, they love manga or something, right? There are a lot of manga fans who learn Japanese because they want to understand manga. The goal wasn't Japanese, actually. So, same thing.
I think the only way is to use it. So not to be shy, try to practice it. And thanks to the internet, now you have plenty of opportunities even to speak with other people, to Skype, to other chat systems, listen to videos, and just do it over and over again, and you will learn it.
Yeah, I think that the biggest advice is that you really shouldn't worry whether you're speaking good, bad. You should just go ahead and speak. And I strongly believe that practice really makes perfect. So that's my advice.
My advice may be from Bruce Springsteen. I think listen to the music and learn. Yeah, I don't know. From Oasis. From Michael Jackson.